Hello everyone, welcome to Trap Shots and I am your host Nishant Krishna. I know it's been a while, but Trap Shots is back and back with a bang. Today's video is about a topic that the whole world has gone crazy about. What was just a piece of fiction has now become reality. Yes, in this video I am going to talk about space tourism and what it holds for you and me. Guys, in case you still haven't subscribed to my channel, please do so and also hit the bell icon to be notified on the next video. I have a lot more interesting videos coming. Now let's get into the topic. First, let me tell you how big this industry is. A lot of analysts kind of predict that the space tourism industry will be worth $3 billion by 2030. That is huge, isn't it? Now who are the top players who are going to dominate the space? Right now, we have the top three global entrepreneurs who are in the space. Of course, the first one is Jeff Bezos, who owns Blue Origin. We have Richard Branson, who owns Virgin Galactic. And there is Elon Musk, who owns SpaceX. What is space travel and how does this happen? Let's understand this better. Let's consider this to be Earth, right? Now, as per international standards, space is roughly about 100 kilometers away from Earth. When Richard Branson, through his Virgin Galactic, went to a distance of 86 kilometers, there was a lot of controversy that, you know, he didn't actually go to space, rather it was 14 kilometers short. But the most strange thing is that most of the US federations have a saying that 80 kilometers is where space lies in. So as per US terms, Richard Branson had been to space, whereas as per international term, he wasn't. In order to avoid this confusion and to avoid any type of controversy, what Jeff Bezos did was he moved to space and he traveled roughly about 106 kilometers, which is actually considered space as per international standards and also as per US standards. That's quite interesting, isn't it? So when we travel to space, are we called as astronauts? Well, the answer is no. So as per the US regulations, in case if you go through the entire training program, only then you'll be called an astronaut. And because these spaceships are computer controlled, people who travel in that are not actually called astronauts, but maybe they'll be called space tourists or something. For Elon Musk, the ambition is at a different level. He wants to take us not just to space, but even to the International Space Station or even to Mars. And that is where Elon Musk's ambitions stand at. Now let's come to the most important topic. When is this going to be a reality for us and how much would it cost us to travel to space? Well, Virgin Galactic is set to start its commercial operations by 2022. It will use this time to make some more test flights using this technology. And do you know what is the price of a ticket? Well, right now, Virgin Galactic has priced it at $250,000 US, which is roughly about 2 crores INR. Well, the seat to be a co-passenger with Jeff Bezos was sold at an auction price of 28 million, which is roughly about 210 crore INR. Well, that also included training, your accommodation and all of that, but still seems to be too far away for a common man to travel to space. While it might not be affordable for us right now, but I think that, you know, 10 to 15 years down the lane, we would all be able to travel to space because with scale, your price would actually come down. And that is what is going to happen probably 15, 20 years from now on. Well, that is a short video about space tourism and what it holds for all of us. Well, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up so that I can create similar videos in the future. Till the next edition, signing off, Nishant.